won't come as a surprise to you to find a KFC in Kuwait, but what you may be surprised by is that Kuwaitis are among the fattest people in the world. We met one group who's trying to change that.
Badr al-Felakawi may be a bit overweight, but this young Kuwaiti is not sitting idly by.
You can really feel it in the abs. It's working the whole ab muscles.
Badr is training for a 10-kilometer run. A year ago, this 37-year-old could barely jog, let alone run. Eventually, his family started to notice.
My kids, you know, looking at me, they were laughing, especially on the swimming pool because I'm a little bit overweight. And that kind of hurt me inside. I will laugh with them, but it kind of hurt me inside.
That's why Badr's braving the muggy autumn heat along Kuwait City's coastline, preparing for the upcoming race. It'll be a big run in more ways than one. Last month, Badr was diagnosed with type 2 diabetes.
It was like a wake-up call and a smack in the face, like I'm really out of shape. I was like gasping for air and couldn't breathe. That's when I decided to do something about it.
Badr is unfortunately not alone in Kuwait. Obesity is a growing pandemic everywhere. But in the past 10 years, Kuwait's become one of the fattest nations in the world. The World Health Organization says nearly 70% of men here are overweight. Things are even worse for Kuwaiti women. Rania Al-Mutawa says heat's a factor. The 36-year-old works out at night because daytime temperatures can soar to 50 degrees Celsius, well over 115 degrees Fahrenheit.
I'm on my sixth lap and it feels absolutely wonderful.
But the real problem, she says, is Kuwait's love affair with fast food.
The average Kuwaiti does not know what goes into that type of food. And it's not fast food and it's not junk food. It's allowed for the kids, it's okay. It's almost like it's hip and trendy to eat at McDonald's and Burger King.
American-style chain restaurants are everywhere these days, but in Kuwait, they're especially popular. Some companies even tailor their menus for the bigger regional appetites.
Hail Pizza Hut's royal masterpiece, the new Crown Crust Pizza.
This is one of Pizza Hut's best sellers in the Middle East, a cheese pizza with a cheeseburger crust. Kuwaitis say their exposure to fast food began during the Gulf War. After all, when American troops travel, their food does too. Local companies are now jumping on the bandwagon. The owner of this Kuwaiti chain said his food was relatively healthy, despite the fact that staff here didn't know any of the nutritional information.
Fast food has a totally different meaning in Kuwait. It's a family affair. In fact, it's sometimes the evening meal. I came here to the mall to order a sandwich, and this is what I got. Six portions. Even if I'm hungry, I can't have all that.
Seems most Kuwaitis are not counting their calories nor measuring their waistlines. But Yusuf Al-Kanai is. He knows just how easy it is to gain weight here. This is Yusuf as a teenager. His excess pounds were shed by running. That's why he organized Kuwait's first marathon, which also includes the 10K race Badr is running. Yusuf blames Kuwait's obesity problem on the country's rapid modernization.
Well, I think it started with Kuwait being a rich country. We have a lot of oil, so this transcends to how we live our lifestyles. It made our life much easier. We don't have to work in order to survive, that kind of thing.
Kuwait is not alone. Neighbors Bahrain, Qatar, and the UAE are also among the heaviest nations in the world, and all face an unprecedented rise in heart disease and diabetes. In 2009, Kuwait became the first Gulf country to launch a healthy meals campaign in schools, but it didn't really help. Government health officials admit that changing the culture was tougher than they first thought. Badr is doing his part.
A year ago, I couldn't run 50 meters. Now I'm going to run 10K. Best part in it, you feel energy flowing in your body. You feel young. And even my wife and kids, when they know that I'm going for the 10K and I'm doing, you know, my workouts, I can sense they are proud of what I'm doing.